So then, hello folks, welcome back to the channel and welcome to the Christmas Eve live stream. So we are on the North Yorkshire Moors Railway and we are going to be rising with this lovely L1 with a rake of 7 Mark 1s. So this should be a nice way to spend Christmas Eve, seeing as most of us are not able to meet up with our families because of COVID. So let's head down to Romont then. So we're in Whitby. I thought as well I'd just show you some of the scenery that I've added since I did the line tour. This is Whitby station. You can see I've added some buildings around the station. I don't know where the level crossing there. Viaducts. That's something that I've added since the tour of the line that I did. You see, I've also added the embankments in the river. I'm going to a bit of a woodland area. Start slowing down for the swap station. So we have two people watching us now, and there's two likes on the stream. Oh, speeding a little bit. So this is the town of Ruswap with the very nice station. You can see I've added a bit of the town in. And of course we go over the bridge and then past a sort of industrial site. Thank you. So this is the town of Slate, and as you can tell, Slate isn't just a big field, so I've still got to add all of the scenery around here. So Slate is only a small platform. So for those of you who want to get the L1 locomotive, it's actually a free add-on on the Rosworth Vale map. It's one of the DLCs, and you'll notice that it costs £0 or dollars and then 0 pence. Or cent, as you Americans call it. So that's how you can get this locomotive. So basically, it's just a free add-on, and it comes with some Great Western four-wheelers and six-wheeled coaches. Oh, speeding again. It's a wonder that they haven't sacked me yet. So here we are at Clermont Station. So this is Clermont Station and the world time is running ever slightly behind, so we just changed that. Now off to Gothland, and then on the way you'll see that I've added some scenery, and I've also added some scenery at Gothland. So once the whole train is in the tunnel, we are able to speed up to 15 miles an hour. And once we get past the yard where all the steam locomotives and diesels are restored and kept, then we can speed up to 25 miles an hour. There's the 57 XX and the Class 31. So we have added the embankment on this side. Speeding up to 25 miles an hour. So you see I've added some trees along here, and now see we are on the railway embankment, which is basically where the ground has been raised in order to make the railway as level as it can be. So we have four people watching us now and three likes on the stream. You need to slow down for the 20 mile an hour speed restriction around this rather short bend. As you can see, I've added the embankment on either side and ridge number 36. Basically going up a steep hill. Under bridge number 34. Slowing down for the 10 mile an hour speed restriction. You can see I've added some grass around here. Here we are at Gothland. You can see the various sidings on either side of the line. So in real life, this one here is a coal drop, but then I don't think you can model a coal drop very well, so it is just basically does sort of look like a coal drop at least. So I've added some scenery in Gothland. You can see I've added all of this grass around here. I've added the embankment along here. This ridge. And then I've modelled the embankment and bridge number 25. You can see we go back down the 1 in 49 gradient down to Levisham. I've also redone the track here at Oakland, because this here used to just go straight on, and there was only a point for the siding here, so I've changed that to how it is in real life. You can see the catch point here, which basically, if it's set in like that, means the train can go up into the station. But if it's set like that, basically means that the train will be derailed because either there is a red signal or because there is another train in the Goffland station. Now we are going back down the one on the way down to Newtondale Halt and then Levisham. So we have 8 watching us live and we have 3 likes on the stream. So there is about to be another 20 mile an hour speed restriction for the sharp bend. We are now approaching Newtondale Halt. We which we will stop at on our way back up to Caromont. So that's after we've gone right the way down to Ickering and then run around the train, as this is only a request stop. We have 10 watching us live now and 3 likes on the stream. So I've still got to add all of the scenery in this part. We need to start slowing down for the 10 mile an hour speed restriction through Levisham. So this is another station that I'm still yet to add scenery to. Big hi to Trainz and more. So this is Leversham Station. You can see we have these signal box, and you have a crossing here. You also have some vans. Well, really, they are these flatbeds with some of the antennas on top. But let's just say they're vans. And a little bit of a freight train here with some sleepers on this flatbed. And some wire on this one. Mo D says hello and hi to you too. So now we are on the Leversham Strait at the end of that. There is a bit of a uphill gradient. Now we are on the big gradient at the end of the Leversham Strait. Oh, it's struggling. It has made it. Gradient. pleasing. So we have now reached the end of the line. We can just see some trees in the distance. And that is where the garage workshop is, where basically any of the coaches that need repairs, they go there to get repairs. So we need to start slowing down, as there is a 10 mile an hour speed restriction over the crossing here at New Bridge, which is this one here. We can also see the garage works. So past some, well, past a long train in the sidings. Oh, there's another bit of train. Oh man, the map's starting to glitch now. Oh, here we are, we have reached the end of the line. And I've added a bit of the town here too. So you can see all the houses around the station. Oh, my map's really starting to have an absolute fit now. You can see I've extended the platform here, so all that we can fit longer trains into the station. The train, you want to aim for about 3 miles an hour with the brakes on. So I'll show you what I mean. So I'll show you a little bit of a trick that I've learned. Stick some of these on. If you want your driver, then navigate to Levisham Platform 1. It will then drive the train for us. Thank you. stick to the speed limits. And when we reach a whistle board, which is basically a big W, it will whistle for us. As you'll see a bit later on. Starting to glitch again. As you can see, it's slowing us down for the 10 mile an hour speed restriction over New Bridge level crossing. Now you will hear the whistle will sound at this whistle board. So folks, the cat has joined me, so I'm probably going to end up shouting at him when he doesn't to sit down and behave. they just fall asleep. Okay, we need to go and change the points at Ghostland. So we'll go do that now. Because we need to be on the left side. Oh, the map's glitching again. Come on. Well, we'll sort it out later. So we need to be on this side, because this side is the up platform in this direction, and this side is the down platform. And if it's this way, you know, it's vice versa, this being up and this being down. Restriction. I'm just gonna try a bit more. Being the down one. we now should start speeding back up to 25. Dale halt. This time we will stop there. It's just a, with it being a request stop, you don't necessarily have to stop there. Unless there is someone on the station waiting to get on, then you have to stop. Maps having a total blooming glitch now. I'm just hoping that we'll be able to get back to Romont before the game has an absolute fit and stops working altogether. We have been streaming for about an hour, which is a good thing. Nope, it's just changed to 9. I just did this outro connection again. Please don't do this game. We're going back up the 1 in 49. I was originally going to use the 57XX for this, but then it really struggled getting up and down this gradient, and it struggled even more on the other side of Oakland where it's even steeper. So at the time using the L1. The map's just absolutely glitching like hell now. Oh, come on, map, stop glitching. I'm gonna stay at the marker one, it's lost its bogeys. I should be a plumber. Right here. Speak of the devil, there it is. So we have two greens on the right hand side of the signal, which means the two points that we're about to go over. So this one here and the next one, which is glitching through. Oh, this is it, that shouldn't have no glitch like this. Which means both points set right, which means we can go over. That's one of those two green signals. Oh, come on, stop glitching. Oh, I just made it worse, shouldn't have done that. We still have got all of the terrain because it's still there. So I'll have to stop it where this signal here is. I don't know what is wrong with this map, but then like every time I blow and use it, it has to glitch. Never mind, let's see if we can get back to Romont. There should be a bloody railway in here. There's no bridge either here. Right. Glitchy as anything to do. Oh, the station's reappeared. Well, folks, it would have been nice if this plumbing map would stop glitching, because I mean, it just looks horrendous at the moment. Oh, hello. That's a bit of the map coming back. I And it's on again. Returned. Oh, it's come back. Slowing down for the yard speed restriction, and then we have the tunnel, which I'm guessing will be non-existent because the map won't load it. Well, I should be at EMU here, class 105, but that's non-existent either. Sexy though. And once again, it says that we have blown no in action. No bottom ups come back. Oh, the tunnels come back, hooray! Lost the map again. Ooh, look, it's the floating train. What a fantastic magic trick. Just whistle for the invisible level crossing here. So I know I have to stop the locomotive at this signal, which is in point 9 of a mile. Oh, the station's come back already. I can see where I need to stop the train now. and the car park markings have come back. So then folks, that's the end of this live stream. Hope you enjoyed watching the map blowing glitch like there's no tomorrow. If you enjoyed the stream, then please give it a like, and if you're new around here or if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to the channel. That's all folks, and I'll see you in the next video.